Blue Prism has 6 different modules that can be accessed either from the tabs on the top or from the navigation bar on the left. Let's take a look at them one by one. Home is the first page that shows up when you sign into Blue Prism, and it displays a default dashboard the user has set under the Dashboards module. Studio is a place where you create the automation process by drawing flowcharts, creating business objects that will interact with other applications, and configure the elements of the flowcharts to do a specific action. The studio has 2 submodules, Process Studio and Object Studio. We'll discuss about these in detail in the upcoming videos. The next tab, which says Control, is called the Control Room. This is the place where you implement and control the processes that you have designed and created in the studio module. This is also the place where you schedule the processes, manage queues and sessions, and allocate resources, which are basically the computers that are running Blue Prism. Then we have the Dashboard module, where you create a dashboard with blocks of graphs and charts called tiles that are dynamically generated from different data sets. These charts are self-refreshing and customizable. The release tab, as you might have already guessed, is the release manager module where you create packages and release files so that you can move the code between various environments like development, testing, and production. Finally, we have the system tab, which is a system manager module. The purpose of this tab is primarily to provide sysadmin functionalities like user account management, setting up environmental variables, storing and managing credentials, managing audit logs, etc. So I believe by now you should have a fair understanding of the different modules in Blue Prism. In the next video, we will see how to create a new user account in Blue Prism.